The inquiry into the NSSF corruption scandal by the Parliament's ad hoc committee continued today, with officials of Uganda Retirement Benefits Regulatory Authority, led by the Chief Executive Officer Martin Nsubuga. Their submissions shocked the committee after Nsubuga revealed that the land title for Workers' House is missing from the NSSF custody. He noted that the title is in the possession of Alcon International, a firm that constructed the Workers' House.
We are able to identify that property volume 2172, folio 10, plot 10, Blickington Road, Workers House, hosting the NSSF head office, has no title. We noted that the land registered issues, the land's registered issues issued a notice for Alcon to return the title, but Alcon did not comply with that notice.
Multi-billion structure.
Workers' House, just to clarify, the Workers' House, not the NSSF House, the one that is own housing there on Pilkington Road.
Workers' House?
Yes. Thank you, Chairman.
It has no title.
However, the Mwine Mpaka-led committee, learned from Uganda Retirement Benefits Regulatory Authority Director of Legal Services, Rita Nasasi, that the fund is pushing to obtain a special title for the land at the NSSF headquarters.
Provided to the authority by the fund, they allege or allude to the fact that they could not trace, while in the process of lifting the caveat, Alcon, I don't know whether it wound up or something, but they say the party, the company, cannot be traced. So that is further information that the fund is in position to provide. However, in a bid to protect the property, because this is members' property, they went ahead to put a caveat. So there are two caveats currently on that title, one by Alcon and another by the fund, just like the director's supervision indicated. And the fund is in the process of applying for a special title, but it has not yet been issued.
Tell us the risk they are exposed to, because when you say the titles are not there, perhaps someone could come out and claim ownership.
All its lawyers did not simply carry the land title, the duplicate for fun. There could be powers of attorney being transferred.
Alcon International took possession of the land title on which the Workers' House sits as security, but later a dispute developed with NSSF over the variance in the contract for the construction of the towers, and the firm withheld the title. But Nasasi allayed fears of the public that the title held by Alcon International is not of any threat, since a caveat had been issued on the same by the fund.
The process of lifting a caveat is by cancellation of that caveat. You write to the Ministry of Lands that this obligation has been discharged by the borrower. You are therefore requested to remove that caveat. It's called an encumbrance, so that the title is free. It's no longer encumbered, because you cannot transact with an encumbered title. So ideally, NSSF should have applied after fulfilling their obligations with Alcon, whatever obligations they may have.
MPs were not convinced, on grounds that there is no way a caveat could have been issued without the engagement of Alcon, which could be having a claim on the land.
Because for you to put another caveat, they would have to first cancel the first caveat of Alcon, which can only be done by Alcon. If NSSF paid the money Alcon was demanding, what was the procedure? Because if you are going to pay someone the balance, there should be an agreement that we are going to cancel the title.
When we succeed in getting a special title, it will still come with the encumbrance of Alcon. And then we shall not have solved the problem.
To make matters worse, Uganda Retirement Benefits Regulatory Authority submitted that Alcon International is not traceable, since it wound up operations and left the country. Uganda Retirement Benefits Regulatory Authority also disclosed that NSSF is yet to transfer part of the Temangalo land, which was procured in 10 years ago in controversial circumstances.
Therefore, the fund still had some titles relating to the Temangalo land that had not yet been transferred into the names of the fund. Those are some of the main ones that we observe, but like I've said, details of that are in our supervision report.
The Minister for Gender, Labour and Social Development, Betty Amongi, also appeared before the Select Committee and rebuked claims by NSSF Board. She told the committee that the board never approved the controversial 6 billion shillings, which was requested by the Minister for Mobilization of More Savers.
Because it relates still to the issue of the 6 billion, which has become a blackmailing issue to the minister who cannot be blackmailed.
Amongi told the committee that the suggestion of the money that has become a hot subject of contention in the probe was within her powers as the line minister and in accordance with the law.
Glad all workers MPs have not contradicted me on this one. And all workers who have appeared have not contradicted me. And recall that I'm a minister for workers. I'm not a minister for elite.
Just tell us again, like you told us yesterday, because the budget that came from all these steps, from the investment committee, from the project monitoring, etc., didn't have the 5 billion. But the budget the minister received had the 5 billion. So where did it come from?
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.